whether you're here live in the room or on either of our live streams or recorded sessions, we have some very exciting presentations. So we have a schedule today with a couple of breaks worked in. So we'll have a group of presentations, a 15-minute break, another group of presentations, then we'll break for lunch. So for anybody that's on site, lunch will be delivered. Having some wonderful empanadas from a local restaurant. We do also have cookies and some other fun. Then we'll resume in the afternoon, another group of presentations, another quick break, and our final group and closing remarks. So that is what the day looks like for us. Also want to do a call out and say thank you to our intern Sarasota County planning team. So Elma's already standing, but if the other team members could go ahead and stand that are in the room today. With this beautiful plan 4 years ago, and thank you to Jonathan for pushing us to start in 2019. Originally, we were going to launch in 2020, and we're so glad we did it because we had everything about COVID and it didn't work out so well. So luckily, we have done this for 4 years, and I have to say this is the best intern group that we've ever had. So round of applause to all of you. Our mentors, because you also made this program possible, so a round of applause for all of them. And I'll turn things over to Jonathan to say a couple words to kick us off this morning.
I don't know. First thing I'm going to say is I really don't remember anybody thanking me back in 18 when I pushed us to start, what was it, Elma, like 4 months?
Yeah, it was 4 months. It was quick. It was really quick.
I don't remember the thank you that. There were words. They just weren't those words. So I'm going to be very, very brief. But first, how is it amazing? Not only Elma's fully committed in, just like the rest of our group who helps make this happen every year, she even enlisted her parents this morning in the back of the room. Elma, just don't worry, I may have embarrassed you a little bit with your parents. So, you know, just to ward it down. But thank you for coming and helping this morning. So I think I told you on the day where they did the opening with y'all, my experience as an intern. I did it both while I was in school, like you all, and I also did post my master's degree as well. And it really set the table for me on the type of person I wanted to be as I went through my career. I've seen a lot of what gets sent to me about the things you've done during the program. And it does look like the class of 22 has been pretty, she's going out there, best class. Some of them might get mad about that. It looks like the class of 22 was pretty awesome, certainly the biggest class. And I'm really excited. This is one of my two favorite days of the year. Where I get to see what you guys worked on and how you put it together and how you present it. So thank you for being here this summer. For those of you who are able, don't forget about us next year as you look at the process. And I can't wait to see what you have. Thanks for being here. Thanks for working with us this summer.
Have to do a plug for recruiting, and we have hired 6 people from the intern program already. We've got 2 of you pending right now for the PEDP program coming up. Many of the interns have already been extended for a week, a couple of months. We'd love to have all of you back next summer if you're still in school or within that graduation time period. Through the exit interviews, I know several have already promoted the program to your friends, so please continue to spread the word. All right, and we will switch over. And first up, we have Brandon.
Well, first I'd like to thank you all for coming to all of our presentations. Everyone put a lot of effort into their presentations and also just the internship in general. So my name is Brandon Hedges, and I was interning with the fire department with fire accreditation. So just a quick summary and synopsis of what I'll be covering. So we'll start with a brief overview of just the 3 phases of fire accreditation, and then talk about the one portion, which was my main focus, the self-assessment manual, and then just a probationary officer evaluations, just a quick snippet of the little projects that I got done, and then just some outside office experience. So there are 3 phases to getting accredited as a fire department. The first is the strategic plan, which was already put in place by Aria, the accreditation manager, before I got here. But I really had to work towards implementing it along with her. And there was also the community risk assessment, which is more on the basis of data analysis, understanding response times, and just having a better understanding of what the fire department does. And then the last thing is the self-assessment manual, which is more of just like assessing the fire department on what it has, what it should have, and just things like that. So this might be a little bit small, but this is what the smart sheet looks like for the self-assessment manual. There's the performance indicator on the right, which is basically what we're trying to go for. The description, which talks about how we're going to that. The appraisal, which is how that's been going for the fire department. And then finally, the plan, which is basically talking about the future of the fire department, what we're going to do to strive to get even better. So another thing that I worked on was the probationary officer evaluations. So this is what it looked like before. It was very wordy, not a lot of like good scoring. The additional comments, there weren't very many, and way too many people had to put signatures. This was brought up by one of the assistant chiefs, Derek Hoyer, in the back there. So this is what it looked like afterwards. A lot less people have to sign it, a better understanding, looks cleaner, a better grading scale, and even an added trending scale. So for instance, if someone had below standards, but they did better than their last evaluation, they could have a trending upwards just to show that they're improving just a little bit. So just for some out-of-the-office experiences, one of the craziest things that happened was I got shot.
Well, not really. It was just for active shooter training, so I was waiting for the fire department to come and save, and it was a lot of work that got put into the training,
and I like that I could just give them a better understanding of what a real situation will be like. Another thing was the fireboat tour, so just understanding marine operations on a day-to-day basis, which I don't have in my hometown. So I also got to use the hose up front. It takes the pump, takes the water, and just shoots it out the hose. So thank you all for coming again, and thank you to the fire department for being such a good family for these last 3 months. Thank you.
At the Culver House Nature Park, creating an integrated pest management plan, or an IPM plan, and that deals with invasive species management. So an invasive species is a non-native plant or animal that causes some sort of harm to an ecosystem or an area. And the main invasive species at Culver House are Brazilian pepper, rosary pea and Peruvian primrose willow, and I've passed out a few samples of that if I can get around. And we manage these species because they reduce the number of natives in Florida. So here are some of those native species that we have at Culver House. We have gopher tortoises, wood storks, bald eagles, and native vegetation such as American beautyberry and wild coffee. Invasive species negatively impact these natives because they outcompete them for resources. They alter the ecosystem's composition and also ultimately reduce biodiversity. So we want to protect that by managing and controlling these invasive species through IPMs. So here are the steps of an IPM. IPM plans promote sustainable management methods while minimizing economic, environmental, and human health risks. So throughout this project, I was able to complete all these steps and implement an IPM plan for Culver House. And so the first step of an IPM is identifying and mapping invasive species. So on the left, you can see is the Culver House Nature Park with the invasive species dots created by a GIS map. And here's a list of the invasive species and a zoomed in zone of one of the zones at Culver House. And just this past Wednesday, we were able to implement a portion of that plan. I hosted a work day at Culver House, where county staff came out to the property and treated zone 4 of Culver House, removing mainly rosemary pea, but also Brazilian pepper and some carrot wood as well. Yeah, so that was very successful. Let's see, and here are just some images from my time at the internship. I really enjoyed all of the experiences that I got to participate in, and I just want to thank my supervisor and mentor for their guidance throughout this process, and thank you to Sarasota County for this opportunity.
Varying stream morphologies on meanders, floodplains, and lower banks to kind of help with the erosion control. And so with the alligator creek projects, the ultimate goals are to reduce total nitrogen input into Linden Bay, which alligator creek flows into. And that will also, and with this project, it will also create lots of different varying nursery habitat for protected species and target species such as striped mullet, red drum. It will also create important habitat for small tooth sawfish, which are very critically endangered ancient species that we want to help bring back into the area. And so yeah, that's the major thing that we've done with them. I also did a lot of other cool little activities, and I got to help with traveling with them, And so one of the activities I got to do were water boat activities. And so basically what a water boat is, if there are netted buoys stretched across a waterway to a canal or a flowing creek or a river, and they kind of help to collect any floating debris, plastic bottles, any sort of pollution or things that shouldn't be in the water. And then we have a team, which consisted of the stormwater department. And we go out there and we remove some of these bottles and pollution, large debris to kind of help clean up the area. And it also kind of stops these things from entering into our lake, which will negatively impact the wastewater quality. And so one of my favorite activities for water sampling. And so I sampled water, bodies of water throughout Sarasota County. And then I used a YSI meter and sonde, and with the meter, we got to get instantaneous parameters such as pH, specific conductivity, temperature, and with the actual sampling bottles, we would collect these samples and send them out to a lab, and the lab would measure the total nitrogen, total phosphorus, it would also measure the chlorophyll levels and the concentration of negative alpha bacteria, such as fecal polymer bacteria, which are bacteria you don't really want to be in the water with. And so probably my favorite activity was the skeletons for me. And so these were fun days on the boat, and as you can see here, we traveled from Sarasota down to Linden Bay to collect skeletal traps. And at each site, there were two skeletal traps with a red or a yellow buoy. And depending on the cycle in the month, we would collect either or. And then you can see here, I would use a hook to kind of bring the net on, or bring the trap onto the boat. And I would cut off the load bag, tag it with the appropriate markers, and then put it in a box, and then I'll replace that trap and then toss it back in the water. And at the end of the day, I'll take all of these traps to the remote marine laboratory, and their interns will kind of sort through the bag, and their main goal was to look for scallops back, which are the larvae of the scallops. And they did this, the purpose of the study is because these scallops are very good indicators of water quality, and so if you have a trap that has very few or no scallop stuff, then you kind of know that that area is impaired and something isn't right. And so during my time here, I also did some community outreach events. So I did two community outreach events at the Shannon Stock Library. And one of them was Oceans of Possibility. So we created a watershed of kind of visual, and it kind of shows the kids how everything in the watershed is connected, even the land. It also talked about ways that at home that they can help kind of reduce the stormwater pollution by using less fertilizers, chemicals, and kind of picking up after their pet waste. And then I also created a brochure that kind of focused on the Southerly Fields stormwater facility. And basically, this kind of showed the background of Southerly Fields, of course, the stormwater facility itself, and how water kind of flows through that system and is treated. And there's also kind of a little section here that's really dedicated to the Sarasota Autobahn Society, because they're also a very important partner in this project. And then I did some remediation site visits. And so these remediation sites are created whenever a wetland or some part of natural area is disturbed or built upon. And so to kind of counteract that, they kind of create these remediation sites somewhere around the area that kind of still helps with the flooding control and water quality treatment with the stormwater runoff. And so this is probably, again, one of my favorite activities, and this was the seagrass survey. And as you can see here, it's a very hands-on activity. We're in the water snorkeling, and we use a 15-meter transect line that's divided into 10 meters. And then we use a little PVC pipe transect, and we measure at every 10-meter interval, we measure the seagrass species, the species composition, the coverage of the seafloor, and if there are any present macroalgae.
But before we started, Luke and I talked about setting some goals. We really wanted to get 5 goals to kind of take the path of the internship, but we're overachievers, so we came up with 11. A good highlight would be completing comprehensive chainsaw training, working with scrub jays, learning about herbicides and getting my herbicide license, and then gaining a broader understanding of operations through working as an attendant. So on Wednesday, I passed both of my herbicide license exams, completing all of them. So I got to complete all 11 goals and have loved every minute of hard work and all of the learning opportunities presented to me. One of the biggest projects I worked on was removing invasive species. So I would say at least once a week I was out there hacking or chainsawing or hand-pulling invasive species. And I learned so much about management plans and techniques of how to maintain a native ecosystem and how that native ecosystem supports our tourism, our happy residents, and our beautiful community. So here are some pictures. The main three invasive species I worked with the most was air potato, Brazilian pepper, and carrotwood. None of them are fun, let me tell you. But here's some pictures of going out there and having fun using a chainsaw or a machete to maintain our native ecosystems. One of my favorite projects is working with the scrub jays at Casperson. We went out to survey these curious little birds, and this endemic species is amazing. It was such a unique experience to be out there collecting data, and it really helped strengthen my passions for protecting these native habitats and going bird watching. And here's some of the cuties that we got to hang out with. We even saw a baby gopher tortoise. Super, super cute. One of the bigger projects I got to play a role in was establishing a seagrass survey at Ted's Berlin Park. We went out in kayaks and we established 8 historic survey points to kind of start a seagrass survey in that area. And collecting data out there was so much fun, being on the kayaks and hanging out with lots of jellyfish, but a lot of other really cool animals, and finding the seagrass. We did it a little bit differently than Chris did. So we went out with 50-foot lines and did a big radius instead of doing transects. So it was pretty interesting to kind of see the difference of how people do seagrass surveys. And then most of my highlights were spent on the water. So here are some really cool pictures and projects that I did on the water. So our goal of being out there on the boats is to increase safety and accessibility of all water access areas in Sarasota County. So whether that was adding new buoys, removing old signs, putting up new signs, or removing trash, we just had a really great time. So this is the buoy deployment. I had to individually kayak out each buoy and anchor into its place out in Ted's Burling to mark the mangrove trails. And then here is some pictures of us fishing for trash, putting no wake signs up, and removing just debris, whether that's a sign that someone had run down or a bottle that somebody had thrown over. But I had a really great summer and learned so much. So I wanted to thank Luke and Alexis for providing me with so many learning opportunities and just being able to be here in Sarasota.
With Sarasota County. So I worked for Public Works Transportation Planning, and the main goal of my work was to facilitate transportation accessibility, mobility, and safety. This improves the quality of life of Sarasota County residents and visitors. So I'm going to talk about a couple of the projects I did. So I worked on Legacy Trail Safety Outreach, and this project arose because of the newest Legacy Trail extension. So this northern extension goes through some urban areas, so there's a lot of road intersections. And because of that, there are different types of traffic control devices at these intersections. So these include hawks, RFBs, and more. Since these are new and relatively rare across the country, some people may not be familiar with them. So to prevent accidents at these intersections, we wanted to educate trail users on how to properly use these devices. And this education was facilitated through an outreach event at the Sarasota Springs Trailhead. So at this event, we interacted with riders. We asked about their experiences or concerns on the Legacy Trail. We shared some safety tips on how to properly use the trail and the traffic control devices, and we handed out some cool bike swag like bells and lights to keep them safe. I also worked to update our strategic safety action plan. So this plan outlines goals which move towards reducing fatalities and serious injuries on our roadways. There are some metrics included in this plan that represent safety performance. So for those metrics, I was tasked with updating them and creating a standard operating procedure on how to best calculate those. So I have a map here that represents the fatal and serious injury crashes in Sarasota County. Properly calculated, and if you can click on one of these points, it gives you some data there, and references a report where you can go into detail to see just exactly what happened with that particular crash. And in addition to those projects, I did some field work around the county. I verified GIS layers by going out on CSD Key. I took part in a road safety audit on US 41. I went around the county inspecting bike repair stations. I looked at a potential placement for signs for the Northport, the new Northport Connector Trail. And I examined existing conditions in order for a proposal to add a paved shoulder to Blackburn Boulevard. So lastly, I'd like to touch on the intern experience here. This is my second year, actually, with the Intern Sarasota County program. And it's just as good or even better as last year. This is such a wonderful program to take part in. There are so many great opportunities and resources and great projects to work on here, and also working with such amazing people. I'd like to give a special thanks to Patrick, Paula, additional staff members, the intern committee, obviously, and all the other amazing interns I get to work with. It's so amazing to work in Sarasota County. There's so many great things to work on and so many great people to work with, so thank you for letting me partake in this internship once again.
My name is Emma Reeser. I'm a senior at the University of Florida. This summer, I got to internship at the Emergency Rental Assistance Program. Through this internship, I learned the connection between paperwork and people, and I'd like to show you guys how. First, I'd like to thank Laura Barnell and Erica Henry, and as well as the entire team for offering me so much help. I'd also like to extend my gratitude to the HR department for organizing the 2022 internship cohort. So the Emergency Rental Assistance Program is a program that serves residents who are at or below the 80% AMI for Sarasota County who have incurred a COVID-19 impact. Through ERAP, there are three stages: the reviewer, the ambassador, and the outreach. Through my internship, I've got to experience each one. As a reviewer, I was able to dive deep into the applications that the Sarasota County residents submitted by analyzing legal contracts, lease agreements, income, and the COVID-19 impact. Next, as an ambassador, I worked at the Gulfgate Library, where applicants were able to visit to ask questions or upload documentation that got them to the final process stage of our program. Through this, I learned vital interpersonal and communication skills that are applicable in my daily life as well in my future career. Finally, I worked on an outreach project with two of my coworkers, where we scheduled interviews with former applicants who are receiving federal funds from the Emergency Rental Assistance Program. Through this, we asked them questions about the organization of ERAP, their connection and communication with other team members of the Emergency Rental Assistance Program, and any suggestions that they had of how we can improve our program in the near future. These responses were recorded and utilized as raw data in a final research project paper that we wrote up. Overall, the Emergency Rental Assistance Program has funded over 1,000 households. Broken down, this is $14 million of aid dispersed into our community. I am so excited about this news because I have seen the steadfast work of the Emergency Rental Assistance Program team on every single application. I am so excited that I've been a part of this process. Thank you.
Take some time to visit with the interns, ask questions on the presentations we've already seen.